As I'm sure you know, atoms aren't easily found on their own. Normally, you find them bonded to something else in an ionic bond or a covalent bond. In this video, we'll cover how to name an ionic compound and how to write their corresponding chemical formula. So, let's start with their formulae. The easiest way to explain this is with an example. So, say you have some calcium bromide. What's its formula? First, write down the symbols for each element. Then, add the charges of their ions by writing how many electrons need to be gained, which would be negative, or lost, which would be positive, to have a full outer shell. Finally, cross the charges and remove the plus or minuses to find out how many of each element are needed to have a stable compound. How about going from a formula to the name? Well, that's pretty similar. First, write the metal first, and then the nonmetal. There's no reason for this. It's just a convention. Step 2 is remove the end of the nonmetal and replace with ide. That's it. However, with transition metals, it's a little different. Because, as you probably know, transition metals have variable valencies, meaning they can lose different numbers of electrons to become stable. If this doesn't sound familiar, I highly recommend my video on trends in the periodic table. Anyways, because transition metals have variable valencies, their ion needs to be specified in the name, using Roman numerals. So, how do you find the transition metal's charge? Well, you just cross the amount of the element up to the top of the other element for both of them, and that's it. Then you just write iron, specifying that it's 3+, the version of 3+, and write oxygen, taking off the end and replacing it with ide. But you might be asking, why does that work? Well, we can see why in this other method that makes understanding the chemistry a lot easier. In Fe2O3, there are 3 oxygen atoms and 2 iron atoms. We also know that the ion of oxygen is O2-, giving the oxygen an overall charge of 6-. That means that the iron must have an overall charge of 6+, in order to balance things out. To find out the ion of iron in this compound, just find what it would need to be so that it adds up to 6+, which in this case is quite obviously 3+. And that's really all there is to naming and writing the formulae of ionic compounds. So if you found that useful, be sure to check out some of my other videos on chemistry, and thanks for watching.